Now then, today in the box, I've got the EUKI D900 5K dual camera GPS dash cam. Now let's give it a go, but first be sure to check my full review below and to press like and subscribe. Now many thanks, and let's get on with it. Now let's look inside the box, and here's the front camera. As you see, revolves 360 degrees. On one side we've got the SD card slot and the function button. On the other end you'll see the USB-C power slot and the port to connect the rear view camera. And the build quality, I think, is first rate. Now next, we've got the 64GB SD card, and that comes pre-installed inside the front camera. And there's a power cable for the front camera, and that culminates in a USB-C plug. Now there's the rear camera, and that connects directly to the front camera to take its power. And the front camera will work separately from the rear camera if you don't wish to use it. Now there's some cable cleats, just to try and keep the cabling neat inside the car. There are two sticky mounts, with two sticky mounts already fitted to each camera. There's a mounting tool. There are two of these electrostatic sheets, and they help to mount the cameras onto the glass. There's a warranty card, quick set guard, and the user guide. And just zoom in and pause to read it. And in fact, this is not the full user guide, just the pages I felt were most important. Now the camera comes with a 64GB card included, but if you plan to do a lot of 5K recordings, you may find a larger one. Maximum size 512GB is required. As soon as the front camera receives power, it will start recording video. And the screen confirms this. It's a nice little screen, but for most cases you're not going to actually need to use it. Now the rear camera connects up the front camera, and again you can monitor it on the screen if you need to. You can fully configure the resolution and other features of the two cameras using the app software, which we'll go into later. To configure and control the dash cam, you need to first install the Jarvis Cam software to your phone or tablet. But first, turn off mobile data and Bluetooth on your phone. Then connect to the Wi-Fi hotspot generated by the camera. The default password is 123456789. Before you change any settings, you have to stop the camera from recording. And just press the video icon to do that. Then you should format the SD card. There's a wide range of settings and options to change, and I'll just go through some of them here. Just zoom in if you need to get the details. Here we can set it to 50 or 60 Hz to reduce any strobing effect. We can set how the rear view camera is configured. We can set the sensitivity of the collision sensor. Now the GPS reading is low because I'm inside the house. We can check photos and videos recorded onto the card, and those recorded due to a collision are kept separately. Formatting the SD card will delete all recordings, including locked ones. You can download local area maps onto the phone, so you can view in real time your location as you drive along. Now we'll have a look at some sample video. Apologies for the reflections and the dirty windscreen. And finally, we'll look at the GPS tracking using the software downloaded onto my Mac. And the software details are included in the user guide. Now this is a lightweight dual mode twin camera dashcam that can give 5K, that's 5K 30 frames per second resolution in front camera mode, and 4K 30 front plus 2.5K 25 rear when in dual camera mode. And that's not all it does. You can connect to the camera over 5G Wi-Fi to configure and control it, as well as to download videos and photos. And oh yes, it's got onboard GPS as well. It's got a high quality screen and it features 24 hour parking mode. And in fact, really, there's not much it won't do. A price of £149.99 before discounts. And yes, there always are discounts. This may be the most expensive dash cam I've tried yet, but I think it's the best. And if you want the best, then here it is.